Well, hi there, and welcome to Sam the Record Man for Ron's Record Reviews again. For look at the T-shirt they gave me here, huh? I'm that kind of person. I am a media tramp. If you have a store, it can be small, I don't care. Send me a T-shirt, I'll wear it. That's the kind of guy I am. And today, of course, we're reviewing albums. First review, Tears for Fears, LP called The Seeds of Love. And these guys had a great LP a couple years ago, and they sort of disappeared for a while. And on this one, they've come back with a very interesting sound, very psychedelic. This one right here sounds exactly like something John Lennon would have written before he hooked up with that woman. But anyway, great LP. It's a lot of fun. It's very esoteric. Can you say that at home? Can you say esoteric? I knew you could. Very unusual sounding. Lyrically, it's nothing particularly strong. I don't think what they're saying is any great important messages. But the sound of the music is the important thing for these guys, and they managed to pull it off nicely. And the vocals have never been stronger with this band. Very impressive stuff. Anyway, so this is The Seeds of Love, Tears for Fears, and I liked it. I thought it was good. Okay, now the next album is called Indigo Girls by one and the same Indigo Girls, as they call themselves. Now, when I first was given this album, because I didn't want to listen to it, it was sort of like shoved under my face, and somebody said, okay, listen to this LP, it's going to be great. And my first reaction was, folk music? Ugh. Remember the big folk music scare back in the 60s when it almost caught on? All those granola munchers and stuff? Well, they're back, apparently, and bigger than ever, sadly. But in this album, I actually liked it. It was a lot of fun. The Indigo Girls are from Georgia, and there's a real hotbed of music down there. And their folk sounds here a little bit sort of mixed with a little country southern twang, and it kind of works. I kind of liked it. Some of the lyrics are neat, too. They talk about some things that may be identifiable to a lot more people than would normal folk music be. I mean, they're not singing about war. They're singing about personal experiences and trying to rise above a caste system that holds them down in place. And I think that's kind of interesting, and it's a noble attempt. Anyway, it's a good album, and on one song here called Kid Fears, which is a wonderful song about the fears of your children, there's a guy on a voice you're going to recognize. It's Michael Stipe of R.E.M., who's a native Georgian as well, and they got together and did a little piece on the LP. So it's a good album. You're not going to get knocked out by it, but it's a nice LP to sit down and listen to and enjoy. The Indigo Girls, and I'd say pick it up. Okay, now the final LP in the review is an LP called Freedom from a man called Neil Young. Now, my first reaction when somebody said, hey, Neil Young has a new album, was, hey, Neil Young, is he still alive? Well, barely. And on this album, he isn't really going to be proving anybody indifferently. You could be watching EKG, boop, 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 and you still wouldn't get it. I've never particularly liked Neil Young. I always thought he was sort of, well, boring. And on this album, he sort of brings back all that wonderful, boring folk stuff from the 60s that we just talked about that I've always hated. Yeah, yeah, yeah. The war's over, pal. Get on with your life, okay? Get a shave and a haircut. Get out and get a job. You know what I'm saying? It's well produced. Beautifully produced. It's lush. It's, you should hear it, Josh. Lush. The orchestration is beautiful. And you think to yourself, wow, this is great. It's going to be beautiful sounding stuff. And then that voice comes in and you just want to, I mean, I turned my treble down on my stereo hoping something would happen, but sadly, no, it was still Neil Young.
I wouldn't say it's deteriorated, Ron. It's about the same as it was even 20 years ago.
Exactly. His voice is the same as it was 20 years. And there's one thing to be said about Neil Young. He does have consistency, doesn't he? He's a very consistent performer. Unfortunately, the consistency is the same as that of Mudd. So I would say, ugh, big pass on Neil Young and Freedom, another Canadian icon down the drain. But of course, he isn't really even Canadian anymore, is he?
Well, I'd say he was. I don't think he's trashed his passport yet.
Oh, he's sold out. He's sold out big time. Of course, I've been always willing to sell out, but nobody wants to buy me. That's it. We're out of here. Goodbye.